Hello divers, what's up? If you are back in our channel, it's really nice to see you, and if you are new, it's really nice to meet you. My name is Aitor and I'm part of the team at Azul Unlimited, where we teach all things scuba diving. So almost like a month ago, one of my favorite brands of diving computer launched a new computer for recreational divers. I'm talking about the arrival of the Seawater Peregrine computer. As a technical diver, I've been using the Petrel Seawater computer for a long time, almost 5 years, either for technical diving, cave diving, and also with my rebreather. But now we have a new computer on the market for recreational diver, and this is the Seawater Peregrine. So first of all, I want to clarify something. I don't have a Peregrine myself. We're still in the middle of the pandemic and it's really difficult to find computers here. We don't have access to any like official shop or sponsor to borrow a computer and test the new Peregrine myself. But I've been waiting for more than a month until some friends sent me feedbacks from using that computer. So now I have enough information to talk about it and give you a first like good or big impression about the computer, the new features that they included, and if it's a nice computer for recreational divers or not. So the first thing that I want to mention about the new Peregrine is the price. They arrive on the market with a really, really affordable price for a computer with those characteristics. The recommended price in the United States is $450 US, and it's not far from similar computers on the market like the Suunto D4 or Crazy, some other computers with similar features. But of course, the new Peregrine comes with a few things that make the difference with other computers. The first one is the color screen. Through the dive, as any other computer, you can read the time, the bottom time, depth where you are, and your nodal compression limit. Also the percentage of oxygen that you are breathing, if you are breathing 21% or any of the nitrox blend available on the computer. If you compare the new Peregrine with my Petrel, Peregrine is way smaller, but the thing is that it's very, very thin, it's thinner, it's a really low profile computer, because that one, the Petrel, is, as you see, is quite big. So if you want to know the real size of the screen, have a look to the Perdix, because they have the same dimensions. The new Peregrine computer came with a built-in vibration alarm. And to be honest, that is awesome, because will be no more beeping, annoying divers underwater. Also, you can set the alarm in 3 different ways. For a maximum depth, like 30 meters, if you reach that depth, the computer will vibrate. Also for the nodal compression limit, like 3-5 minutes before getting in Indico or reaching your nodal compression limit, you can set the alarm. But also for the maximum bottom time or the plan of the day. If your plan is to dive for 45 minutes, the alarm will go on when you reach that nodal compression, or sorry, that bottom time. As I said before, some of my friends, they already test the computer, and they told me that the vibration is powerful enough to feel over a thick wetsuit or even a dry suit. Some of them, they are diving right now in California with dry suit, with really cold water, awful water, and they said that it's no problem, that you can feel the vibration with no problem at all. Next topic that I want to mention is the battery. Okay, on my Petrel, what I have is a cap on the side. Okay, I will do a close-up later, where you just need to unscrew and place a AA battery. With the new Peregrine, it's different. What you have is a wireless charger, like the one from your phone, where you just put it on top and get charged. So that means if you are on a diving trip and you run low on battery, if you have a power bank with you, between the surface interval, you can charge the battery enough to do a couple of extra dives. Anyway, the lifetime of the battery is, by the manufacturer, is 30 hours. Based on my friends, between 22 to 26 dives with no problem. And long dives, like 55 1-hour bottom time dives. So remember that we're still doing recreational diving and we don't dive normally more than 1 hour if we go with a diving operator. Then the settings, okay? The 4 different modes that came with the new Peregrine. So for diving, we have the air mode, where you dive with air up to 21%, okay? No changes, just normal air, compress on your tank. The second mode is the Nitrox. Nitrox mode, as any other computer on the market, from 21% up to 40%. Well, actually 22%, that is considered already enriched air nitrox, up to 40%, because it's for recreational divers. This is important because the third mode is the nitrox mode up to 100% of oxygen. But here the difference is that you have three different gases to choose. So you can set on your computer three different blends, for example, nitrox 36, nitrox 50, and nitrox 100% of pure oxygen, okay, 99%. If you want to do something more technical, again, this is not a technical computer, it's for recreational divers, but if you want to grow a little bit and expand your comfort zone and do some decompression dives with one deco gas or one stage, you will be able to do it, because on the third mode, where you can choose between three different gases, you can set your breathing gas or bottom gas and then the stage to do the decompression stops. The difference between Peregrine and other computers like the Petrol is, on the Petrol you have a bunch of gases, like six different gases, that you can turn on and off through the dive. Okay, so you set the six different gases before, including helium, and then you choose them through the dive. But here with the Peregrine we have one mode that is really simple, with only one gas for nitrox, and then when you take some training and you are a more advanced diver, you can choose the second mode with three different gases. And the last mode is the gauge mode, just to read the depth where you are, to use it as a bottom timer. You know, you can use it as a backup computer with a bottom timer if you are doing some technical diving, or for free diving. I will not recommend it, but who knows, if you don't have anything else with you, why not? Then the logbook. How do you log your dives? Well, you have a Bluetooth connection, you have a software to download on your computer, your laptop, tablet, and through the Bluetooth you can download all the dives with diving profiles, bottom time, the usual guys. But also, if you want to check your dive profile, you can do it on real time on your computer. You don't need to wait to download the profile on your laptop or tablet. Now, what is not included on the new Peregrine? For me, that is a weak point, okay? One of them is the compass. Doesn't have an integrated compass or digital compass, and I use a lot my compass on my seawater, on the Petrel. But again, you can use another compass on your wrist, or maybe on your console instrument, an external compass to navigate. But it's something that, I mean, it's nice to have everything integrated on the same computer. The second thing that is missing for me, I'm not a big fan of the AI. I don't know if you know what that means. AI is the integrated air, or the transducer, that you can use to connect your first stage high pressure port with your computer to read the pressure of your tank on your computer with a wireless connection. Let's talk about the
algorithm.
I don't know if I say it correctly, but algorithm. I will write it on the screen. So, as a recreational diver, that is also not something not really important for you, but the algorithm that the computer uses is a Bollman algorithm. What does it mean for you as a diver? Okay, at a recreational level, it's not that important, but a clear example, when other computers like Suunto, they use a different algorithm, is when you go for a dive with a few friends, and almost at the end of the dive, you're still having no decompression limits, like for example 15 minutes at 12 meters or 13 meters, and your fellow divers, your friends, they are already almost on the safety stop because they don't have more bottom time. Computers, they are really conservative. That means those computers, if you dive the same profile obviously, those computers, they are not using the same algorithm. It's using a different one, like the ones that Suunto use. Ask any professional on the industry, dive master, dive guides, instructor, Suunto computers like the Gecko, the Soup. For us, I love them. Eh? I love that brand, but they are a pain in the ass to guide people because you run out of button time really, really quick. And it's not because you go deeper or you spend more time at the episodes, because the algorithm is different. Another extra point for this computer, well, not for the computer, for the brand, is that they remove all the single-use plastic from the packaging. So when you get it, you open it, it's not any plastic inside. What you will find inside the box is the computer, the strap. Yeah, the strap is like a watch rubber strap, really big, yeah, as any computer for the wetsuit or the dry suit. So you have no problems using that strap with the dry suit, but also include a couple of bungees. The ones from the side mount, for example, the side mount equipment to hold the tanks on the side of your harness, similar bungee. Also, underneath the box on the inside, you will find some tools, screwdrivers, just to work on the computer, so to remove and put it back the strap. Another extra point for the brand is the guarantee of the computer. They will give you 2 years of guarantee for the computer, and if you have any problem, just send it to the manufacturer or any like official repair shop, and they will take care of it. Perfect. So only to recap, I want to mention again, the price is $450. The recommended price in United States is an excellent computer for recreational divers with an open mind to become future technical divers and take one step on with the different modes that the computer offers for nitrox, up to 100%, 3 different gases, the low profile, the battery, battery lifetime is amazing. For me, it's really comfortable to do like 20-25 dives and then just charge the computer again or replace the battery on mine. So I think this computer will be on the top 3 of the best computer of the next couple of years, because it's really nice looking, the features that they offer are amazing, and also the brand is just incredible. I'm in love with that brand of computer since 5 years ago, as I told you before. Okay friends, so it was really nice to see you again back in our channel, and if you are one of the new ones, give it a thumb up, subscribe, and I will see you on the next video. And let me know if you have any question about this specific or particular computer, any other computer, if you want me to review any piece of equipment, any recommendation, guys. If you want me to shave, I will do it, maybe not, it depends. I still with the pandemic look on my face. So yeah, see you soon, guys.